In service manuals, we find most of the information that we need to repair equipment, but they are limited. For example, if there is a camera or screen problem, the service manual will indicate where the circuit responsible for the camera is located. In our cases, it is located in the area number 7. It also presents additional important information, such as the shielding of the motherboard, which are identified with the word sheet following by a number. It is important to take this information into account to make the repair efficiently. It's silly to remove a shield if we don't have the integrated circuit we are looking for underneath it. The name U5002 is not enough to make a detailed study of the electronic circuit. It's necessary to know the real code of it, such as S2MPU08A026030, to be able to consult the data of the datasheet and make a more profound analysis. The datasheet is a document that contains detailed and specific information about a product, device or component, such as its description, specification, characteristics, function, application, price, and so on. This information is provided by the manufacturer and is necessary for user, professionals and other interested parties to know the details of how the product works. Datasheets are a very useful tool to understand the product and the uses that can be given to it and help to make informed decisions when we are buying or using a particular product. We practically have all the inputs and all the outputs of the circuit, also the grounds. In this way, we will be able to find difficult failures. If we don't have a schematic in particular for a circuit, it is advisable to look for the same circuit in other models to make an adequate diagnosis. This is because the same circuits are usually similar between different models, and so we obtain additional information for our diagnosis. The code is important for us since it provides information about the circuit in question, including its function and where it can be found. We note this code on mobile one touch page to be able to locate the circuit more easily. If we don't find the circuit, we erase the numbers from the end of the code to avoid confusion. This helps us to keep an accurate record of the circuits and their functionality. In the DZKG layout, we can find the exact position of the integrated circuit and the shields. This is achieved by using a detailed arrangement diagram, which shows the components and their specific location on the motherboard. If the schematic plan of the particular model is not available, useful information can be obtained from a similar schematic plan. This implies that the same lines, bobbins and capacitors are the same amount of LiDO, BOST and microphone must be followed. This can be very useful for any diagnosis. A good electronic diagnosis requires a methodical and orderly process in which the appropriate steps must be followed to obtain the necessary information and evaluate it correctly. This implies firstly identifying the problem, then performing tests to establish a diagnosis, determining the related components and systems, and finally applying an appropriate solution. This must be done carefully and with the greatest precision possible, taking advantage of the accumulated experiences to solve problems efficiently. It is important to store all the electronic motherboards, regardless of the brand, to ensure a variety of options when a specific model of PMIC, charging IC or other circuit is needed. To store all these electronic motherboards efficiently and safely, we recommend to create a categorized file system by brand. In this way, each brand will have a dedicated drawer for its products, which will help to locate them quickly. So, when you don't find a specific schematic manual, don't give up the job. Use these tricks to keep going with the diagnosis. We can also find white label mobiles that are very similar to other models. You have to analyze the circuits well. You have to open your eyes and look for alternative solution. Every day you'll acquire more and more experience. I just show you the way. The difference between two similar motherboards is the structure of its design. For example, one motherboard can have the bobbins located on the top of the circuit, while in the other they are located at the bottom. Both motherboards will have the same inputs and outputs, although their physical arrangement may be similar. To identify a damaged circuit, the first thing to do is to identify it, which is relatively easy. If we don't have the schematic, we must verify the models compatible with the circuit to make an appropriate diagnosis. For example, for the Samsung Galaxy A40, we can use the schematic of A10, A20, A30, M20, A40S. We have a big variety of compatible models, so there are no excuses to diagnose. In this way, the inputs and outputs of the circuit must be counted. For example, if there are 11 bobbins or inductors, the 11 input capacitors must be counted. Once this is done, we can measure the impedance, voltages, and other parameters that we have learned at the beginning of this course. In this way, we can solve a larger number of failures even without having a complete schematic. It is important to remember that there are very complex schematics, but there are also very simple ones. This should not be an obstacle to continue with the failure. Every day we have to learn new tricks to repair effectively. At first it might seem complicated, but over time and with practice, we'll acquire a lot of speed when we are repairing.